Okay, testing 1 2 1 2. And we're good. Right. What do I need? I don't think I need anything for this bit, actually. Yeah, only 2 discs. Sorry, Chris. No getting rescued for you. I don't think I need any key items either. Let's update something real quick, 1 second. Right, okay. Oh, there is a few. Yeah, might as well. There's quite a. Oh crap! There's quite a few zombies to take care of. I really like the design of the pistol. It reminds me a lot of RoboCop's pistol from the original RoboCop, not the remake. Yep, he's not mutated yet. There we go. Right, computer passwords, that's what I need to do. And I went ahead and wrote them down. Because I remember, I think it was on my playthrough of this that I originally uploaded. I actually had to look them up in the run because I just forgot what they were. They did change them though. They're not actually the same in this. This door, right? Yep. I always remember the Ada and John, but it's the password I always used to forget. It is John with an H, right? Is it John with an H? Oh, wrong way round. That was stupid. Oops. Ada F. Not quite. This is what you get from doing the X-rays. You get cell as the password, which always is kind of funny. But I just couldn't be bothered to do that. It just takes a lot of time. Yeah, that's the prison room. But if I don't have all 3 discs, I don't think I can get Chris out anyway. So sorry, Chris. Unless there's a disc in the lab, which I don't believe there is. You're kind of out of luck, I'm afraid. Just noticed I forgot to update my stream name. Ah, yeah, no, this is the final disc. It's weird, like how how futuristic these looked, back when this game came out. They looked like it was like, man, they just looked really cool back when the game came out. And then mini discs actually happened, and were kind of terrible. And then that was it. Like, mini discs just seemed to, come and go so quickly. Oh no, I need the I need the film, don't I? Yeah, that's right. Oh, I know where I need to go. I remember. Almost like I played this before. This isn't the cell I unlocked, it's this room. I could have swore I just heard something. Thought so. Wow, is there actually like. Oh yeah, there is actually like a space. There's like a hole in his head. You can see me when I walk past it. That's really cool. Well, he's still kicking. No, wasn't actually hitting him. There we go. This seems like a really weird security system. Oh, he's actually dead. All right, here we are, yeah. Film is in here, and then I get the film. And that gives me access where I need the cartridge. Some more flame rounds. Q. Or incendiary. Oh, I'll have to go back to the item box. Why would there be ink ribbon in a laboratory? I mean, they have computers here. Like, what's going on? Oh no, hang on. This way. Getting ahead of myself. Ah, yeah. I've got to do this first. Was that 8462? Yes, it was 8462. I think that's always the same, though. Right, so I've got my key. That's the exact same key that's in Resident Evil 2 in the in when you're in like the laboratory area of RE2. Oh yeah, this is super creepy. Where's he aiming though? Yeah, let's just skip that. It's like, where is he aiming in that? Like, that zombie's moving pretty damn slow in a fairly narrow corridor. It would seem he's got a fairly easy shot at taking that zombie out, and he still doesn't manage to do it. Filled this up. It's funny, like, I mean, those things are like what? I think they're like 5 gallons or something, those gas canisters, and yet you can only refill like your little, hip flask thing like twice out of them. That doesn't make any sense. All right, offload my stuff. I'll just leave that in here. I might. I don't actually think there's any zombies left at this point, except the ones that are in the hallways. And I don't need. I won't need that for them, so I'll hang on to those, take that, and I think we're good. The laboratory section's always longer than I remember it being. I think they made it a little bit longer in the remake, because in the original, because you know, I don't think you have to do the part with the film in the original. So in the original, I think it's, oh no, I think you'd have to do the part with the film, but not everything else, like the x-rays and stuff. So I think the original is basically, you get the film, and then you go, you know, you go through the main door, down in the lift, and then like turn on the power, and that's it. Because they added the whole fuel canister thing in this game, where you can't run with it, otherwise it'll explode. That adds on, you know, a fair bit of time. Is that not it for that door? Is this door? No, I don't want to discard it. I want to keep everything. Yeah, there's more zombies in here. Well, or at least there usually is. Never mind. Ceiling hunter's time. I should have probably bought a bigger gun for this, because I don't think these guys are pretty tough. Ah! Get off me. Okay. Scratch what I said about them being tough. Man, easy mode is really easy. Right, let's grab this. Or, yeah, I was going to say, can I not grab it yet? Fuel may explode if shaken or... Really? Like, could they have not found a better, you know, like, fuel than something that is that volatile? Right, so that was what, like, I think 3 pistol shots from this thing killed it? Although this pistol is quite a bit more powerful than the default pistol. Where are you going? You're dead. You ain't going nowhere. I could have swore there was one more. Maybe not. Yeah, this pistol's pretty OP. Pistols have a fairly good track record of being, like, kind of ridiculously powerful in Resident Evil games, though. I knew you were coming. I've played this game before. Ah, yeah, I thought there was another one here. But yeah, you think there's this pistol, Leon's pistol in RE2 is pretty broken once you upgrade it. Claire, when she gets the in RE2, when you go through on hard and get the closet key, Claire actually gets a new pistol. And it's like an old school revolver. Okay, I didn't think there was another one. Take that. And that basically fires like kind of at the same speed as you know, Leon's upgraded pistol, so makes pretty short work of a lot of zombies. And she actually has like the kind of, you know, single action fire from the hip animation as well, which I thought was pretty cool. Okay. What do you have to? Is it around here? So do I need... Right, I remember. I need the fuel first. You don't power it on at all without it. I want to try and make sure I've killed all these hunters. Because it's always the one that you forget to kill is the one that hits you when you've got the freaking fuel and then you die. And that sucks. Right, okay, we're good. What are you doing? Come back. Come on. Where is he? I can hear him. There he is. Trying to sneak away on me. Oh, I blew his head off. They're an enemy I'd really like to see come back. The ones in RE5 were basically the same, but in this one, you know, I think you can tell they're like, I don't want to say ripped off, but you know, they are very, very reminiscent of the Fly, you know, from that film. So like, and the ones in RE5 were more like, you know, they kind of got rid of a lot of that. They just made them like just kind of generic bugs. They just look like giant bugs. They look like more something out of Starship Troopers than you know, what they were in this game. I don't need to go in there yet, so. Although I could do with offloading this key. We'll wait. I still haven't gone through this game as Chris. That's just dawned on me. Chris is. Chris, I do actually think Chris has the better campaign in this. You know, he has the better story mode. The only thing with Chris is that when you go from 8 item slots to 2, it's a huge difference because if you carry, I usually carry like, you know, the pistol and the pistol ammo, and then I carry the shotgun just always fully loaded. You don't necessarily need to carry extra shotgun ammo just because it's so powerful. But with Chris, like, that's half your item slots taken up. Well, you're an ego one, aren't you? Yeah, sit down. Sit down. When Jill Valentine tells you to do something, you do it. Have some respect. Right, so fill this up, and now I can't run for a limited time. I like how they put running in red. Like, yo, you shouldn't run with this. I think you can actually run a little bit. I don't know how much you can run though. It's not a good idea. I haven't saved, so, you know, let's just take a nice slow walk. Wonder how many bullets it's going to take to down the tyrant. I can't remember. I know back when the game was new, someone worked out how much more powerful this pistol is than the regular one. I think it was, if I remember rightly, I think it was at least twice as powerful. That's not where I need to go. I love how grimy the laboratory is in this version. They weren't really able to do that in the first game, you know, because it was on the PS1. They were so limited by hardware. Whereas in this one, like, just how run down and just, you know, old the laboratory looks. It's I've I always that was always one of my favorite parts about the remake was how they just made the how you know they made the mansion, the guardhouse, pretty much everything. They made it look, you know, so abandoned and so derelict. Whereas in the first game, because it was on the PS1, they just couldn't really do that. You know, the laboratory looked pristine because, you know, they didn't, you know, they couldn't really texture the walls or, you know, do anything kind of fancy with it. Now, I wonder what's in that fridge. I'm just saving here just in case there happens to be one hunter that I haven't killed who freaking hits me and then I'm dead. This makes me want to play Resident Evil 2 a lot. I always get that urge when I play Resident Evil 1. I just want to play Resident Evil 2 and 3 like immediately afterwards. Still waiting on the Resident Evil 2 and Resident Evil 3 remakes. I have faith that one day they will happen. That's what I thought they were going to be, actually. I remember when this came out on the GameCube, there was like a little sleeve in the back of the case behind the manual. Shoutouts to manuals. And actually said, you know, Resident Evil 2 and 3 coming soon to the GameCube. And like quite a lot of people, including myself, assumed that's what it was, you know, that it was going to be remakes. And they were just straight ports, you know, they didn't do anything to the game. They obviously benefited from, you know, virtually zero load times because they were on, you know, a DVD, and they had, you know, a more powerful system behind them. But no, they were just the basic ones, and that was always a little disappointing. And I remember when they came out, they were by default, they were like the greatest hit price for anybody that doesn't remember that. I've done it again. I do this every time I play this game. I think you have to come straight here with the fuel, but you don't. You've got to put it in the damn bit where you've got to put it. And I always have to walk back. I don't. I seriously don't think there is a time I have played through this game where I haven't done that. That is annoying. What was I saying? But yeah, about the GameCube versions of 2 and 3, they came out at like greatest hit prices back then. I don't know if even Xbox. I think 360 had it. I think, and PS3 definitely had it, but I'm not sure if PS4 and Xbox One have got it. But they used to have like a greatest hits line. For PlayStation, it was Platinum. You used to get like a silver case, and it used to like invert the colors. Instead of black and white on the case, it was like silver and black. And sometimes you'd get bonuses in them, sometimes you wouldn't. And Xbox, I think, had like Xbox Classics, and I think 360 had Greatest Hits or something equivalent. I think GameCube had Greatest Hits, and it was basically when a game sold X amount of copies, they would go platinum, and they would always be half price. You know, if you bought it new, they would always be £20, for example, here in the UK. And Resident Evil 2 and 3 launched on the GameCube at £20, and I remember thinking at the time, like, I don't want to pay that for those games. But it turns out they had such a limited run that when I finally ended up buying them, I think I ended up paying, I think it was 30 for both, maybe more for Resident Evil 2. Resident Evil 2, for some reason, was always more expensive. And it just, I always remember thinking, like, man, if I'd just bought them, you know, all those years ago, I would have been able to save a little bit of money. Because I mean they're extremely rare. There was a few GameCube games like that. The Metal Gear Solid 1 remake, the Twin Snakes, which was, you know, kind of like a full-on remake of the PlayStation 1 version. That's the same. I remember when that came out. That was actually a full-priced game though. That was full price launch. That was £40. I remember when that came out, I thought the same thing. Like, I don't want to pay that for that game, even though it was fantastic. And if I was, you know, if I had more money at the time, of course. I probably would have. I would have bought it straight away, and I bought that probably a couple of years ago. I think that cost me about 70, about 60 or £70 for that, like a brand new version. Just someone, you know, off of eBay that obviously kept it. So yeah, you know, moral of the story: if you want something, buy it. Just buy it, because odds are you'll probably end up paying more than you should further down the road. I just realized I'm still yet to play through that. The Twin Snakes remake. I've played it just to obviously make sure it works, but I haven't actually played through it yet. There could be a stream in that somewhere. Right, so what do I need to do now? I can't remember what's in the room that is usually poisoned, because the room that's out of here and on your right as you exit is usually a poisoned gas room. Because, I mean, you know, what else are you going to have in your laboratory except a poison gas room? It's where you know, send uncooperative employees. So, but there might be items in there. So let's go check. 60 ink ribbons, living large. I want to save them because I want separate ammo because, you know, I'm weird like that. I'll sort this stuff out in a minute. One thing that was really cool about the director's cut on the PS1 of Resident Evil as well, they had, I think it was actually called training mode as a difficulty, and you got double ammo in every single ammo pickup, which was pretty ridiculous. You ended up, I think, I remember going through the game when it not long after it was out, and once you actually got the shotgun. Because it, and you got more ammo pickups as well throughout the game. Once you got the shotgun, oh no, it's the other door, isn't it? Once you get the shotgun, you actually have enough shotgun ammo to go through the entire game using nothing but the shotgun because you just get so much ammo for it. Every ammo pickup is 14 shells, and the enemy count in, you know, the original game is far less than what it is in this one. All right, now pay attention. I don't want to like suddenly die here. What's that noise? I probably should have saved before I did this, but we're just gonna do it. Check you. Sneaky little shit. Damn, I'm on caution. And there's no green herb stash in the laboratory. Okay, so there's like what, nothing? Is there nothing in here? Doesn't look like it came from surgery. Jill Valentine with those crime scene skills. Yo, check you out. Try and hit me. Right, okay. That's where I came through. So I can go through here. And this... Aha! That's what's here. It's funny how they look like GameCubes. It's a pretty big nod to the original version of this game. Oh, what's that? Oh, a battery. Lovely. And does that just let me get out? Yeah. Alright, so... God, I'm trying to remember what used to be in there in the original. It might have been the same thing, but there was definitely a trick to the room, whereas like if you screwed up, you got poisoned. So that's all the... Okay, so let's go rescue Chris. We might as well. Can't leave Chris hanging. Can't remember what the parameters are to get, you know, like the best ending. Yeah, I can't believe I haven't played through the Twin Snakes. I have to clear some time. Oh, yeah, if only, Jill. If only they all had green lights on them. One thing I love about Resident Evil is, like, the reused sound clips. Like, though this sound right here on the lever, it's in so many Resident Evil games. As is that door unlocking noise. It's weird how, like, graphically this game still looks pretty good, but it's weird how kind of lifeless, you know, faces and eyes looked at this point in gaming. You know, no one had really figured that out yet. Because, like, you look at their eyes and it's just kind of, they just look, like, so flat, you know, that there's nothing really there. Right, okay, so I can't really do anything with Chris yet. It's like, oh, hang on. I really want to get through this without using any health. Fortunately, like, the first tyrant fight is always really easy. Like, because he's so slow, you just have to run and just shoot him. He's really not that hard. You can even use the regular pistol on him. All you have to do is kind of just do laps. Where the hell am I going? You just have to do laps around the regular bit and just, you know, put plenty of shots on him. I don't think he even takes that much to knock out on easy. I'd imagine it's like less than a magazine. Okay, we're going the right way now. Hey, it's the traitor. Like, why does Jill let him off? I just don't understand that. Like, he clearly screws you over. Oh. Hello. More shotgun ammo. That right there is the Resident Evil 2 noise. Right, let's get out of here real quick. Okay, I was really hoping he'd get stunned. Wow, is that it? Yeah, take that. Right, okay, let's go talk to Barry and, revive him. Why am I always saving your ass? I could have swore he got stunned after six shots. That noise right there is in the original Dino Crisis and Dino Crisis 2. That noise unlock. Man, I love those games. We need a new Dino Crisis game. I'm not sure. I'm not really sure what they were thinking with Dino Crisis 3. Well, it looked really good. Remember that being one of the early Xbox games that was just, super impressive on a technical level. But the game just wasn't really anything. Like, I mean, the first Dino Crisis really was just Resident Evil, but with dinosaurs instead of zombies. But the second Dino Crisis was much more like of an arcade-style shooter. With the scoring and everything. Right, so let's go through all of our stuff and let's see what we've got. Okay, so that's what? Eight first aid sprays? Man, this is a lot of green herbs. Shit, I did not mean to use that. Okay, so add one onto whatever we've got. There's not as many red herbs as I remember there being. Which I guess is kind of balanced when you consider, they are full heals, essentially. Still a lot of green herbs to get through. Right, so that's all my green and reds. How many blues have I got? There's only three blues left. I like how it almost goes like gold when you combine all three. Where'd they get the paper from? The instant combine would make this a lot easier. It's like the one good thing about Resident Evil 6. Which is still being fairly generous. Oh, I just remembered I didn't actually open my first aid boxes yet either. these have I got? 5. That's really convenient. Two green herbs. Green and blue. Two greens. Okay, we might as well do a 2 green and blue. It took me until, I think, Resident Evil 3 to figure out you could actually do 2 greens and a blue. I just never thought of doing it. Cool, the first aid spray. The first aid spray. Sweet. Right, so that's every single healing item. I haven't used any. That's 1 green and 1 blue, and that's 2 blues. I always used to organize them in, like, you know, strength of, you know, how they could heal you. Because I'm, you know, kind of a nerd. Man, we are still not done with these herbs. How many have I got left? Oh, not many. Always, like, I always kind of have the muscle memory left over from the previous Resident Evil game for combine and everything. Because in some games, they have combine as the second option instead of the third. So I always end up pressing that one. And there we go. Alright, let's grab my pistol. Man, that's a lot of stuff. All the keys. I'm not sure which is actually quicker now, doing it this way or doing it the other way. I think there might be more keys than that. Let me just double check. Nope, that's all of them. And there you go. So that's every single item. If you ever wondered what is in a full playthrough, you now have your answer. Oh, and however many, like, rounds I used on the spider with the grenade launcher. You can go back and check the video. So, it's quite a lot. Although you still hardly get any magnum rounds. Like, they're still always really stingy with the magnum rounds. There we go. Right, let's just put in a save. So we've always got this. I kind of wish you had more save slots, though. I don't see why you only have 8. Right, let's bring out the big guns. And I'll just grab some healing stuff. And let's go fight the tyrant. Wrap this up. Even though at this point in the game, essentially, this is wrapped up because I have done what I wanted to do. Just wanted to get, you know, every single item in the game recorded. For no real purpose. I was originally intending just to post it as like a standalone video. But having like, you know, this new setup and streaming and that being a lot easier than it was, I thought, why not? Do I have to go and get Chris or yo? Check him out. Sorry, Chris, but I can't be bothered. I hope you're there. That's all I can say. But yeah, like this setup, it just makes streaming so much easier. I used to stream directly from my capture device when I did my like Resident Evil stream. Probably, oh man, that was probably a lot longer than I think. I think that was like 2 or 3 years ago now, actually. The charity stream I did for Resident Evil. And I think I only streamed one other time after that. And that was all through my capture setup, which was still fairly good. Like, it was, you know, fairly straightforward. But now I'm using XSplit and just kind of using it through the same route. And it just makes streaming just so much easier. It's so much easier to set up. It's so much easier to just kind of, you know, set everything up, hit stream, and then, you know, I'm good to go. It's much less hassle than kind of syncing everything like I had to. Oh, there's more stuff here. This is ruined. This like kills my OCD that there's more stuff here. Why? Why are you doing this to me? I don't think I can go back now either. Okay, so it's a first aid spray. Alright, let's waste that. So add like one more first aid spray. So, the reason I'm getting rid of it is because there's the battery coming up, and you need a free item slot to pick it up. And a green herb. Awesome. I think that actually rounds out all of my herbs to like a, you know, an even 3 herb mix as well, which is cool. Like the weirdest looking battery ever. Fuse unit. It's just a battery in the first game. Try that one. Oh, and how many defense items? 13 daggers and 11 stun guns. It's a fair amount. I think that's still probably the best addition to this game they ever did. I was really disappointed that wasn't in Resident Evil Zero. I suppose in that one you have your partner to kind of help you know, if you get hit. Or if any enemy, like, not many enemies actually have like a kind of a grapple state though, like they do in this game. Quite a few enemies have a state where they can actually, you know, kind of grab a hold of you, like the zombies, the dogs, the hunters, just off the top of my head. I don't know if you can actually use defense items on sharks. Probably not. I might have to try that actually. Right, let's swap over to the Magnum. Because, yep, I've got to fight the tyrant. Oh yeah, you can do the quick fire trick. I love that. I don't know if that was actually in the GameCube version. I remember finding it when I started playing this on the playthrough. Yo, Barry, help me, help me, help me. Shoot him. Or just kick him in the face. Okay, let's actually equip those, because, you know, that was almost a very bad day right there. Never mind, take that. Now, I think you can actually kill him without using this, but, you know, I mean, where's the fun in that? Item screen, please. Now, is he gonna reflect it? Oh, damn, John is online. Yeah, he deflects it. For anyone who doesn't remember, that is John from the podcast way back when, the Mighty Electronic Box, one of my co-hosts. All right, so you do have to go pick up Chris. Sorry, Chris. No Resident Evil 5 for you. No insane, you know, buff up workout for you. So almost 5 hours to get every single item in the game. That's not too bad. Not too bad. Let's just save it here. So what does the purple font mean? I don't really know. But anyway, that's going to do it for this stream, guys. I will see you in whatever I do next. I might try and get the GameCube working and do the Twin Snakes. I think that would be a really fun game to play through again. It's been probably been ever since it came out, basically, because when it came out is when I last played it. I rented it and played through it, and that was it. Never played it again. So that's probably, what, at least 10 years ago at this point? Maybe more. So that might be the next game I do. So peace out, everybody. Hope you enjoyed the stream, and I will see you next time. Peace.